Hello and welcome back to a new video about hydraulics. Now with an application, with an example of an application. I show you now a picture of one hydraulic tank and all the things which are built upon this tank. So have a look at this. Have a look at this. This is a hydraulic tank. During commissioning time, so you see there are a lot of stuff lying around and so on. In operation, this looks much better, cleaner, also the floor is then filled with tiles and so on, but this is during construction. So what do we see? Here is the tank. The below part here is the tank. Here, those things here, you can unscrew and open and climb in to clean and whatever, look what's going on inside. Here is an indicator of the level of the oil inside that you can observe. Those things here, those stickers, they're typical commissioning things. Because, you start, you don't know if there is any leakage in your oil system or whatever. So you place those stickers on, and see if you're losing oil or maybe it's getting more oil. More oil is also very suspicious, because then usually it's not oil, usually it's water. But however, then there is this water warner. I told you, there are water warners where there's a swim inside and the water will be accumulating at the ground of the tank because oil swims on water. And so if there is the density not correct for the oil, this water warner will say, there is something. So this is the tank here. The oil reservoir. Here is a control cabinet. Here's a control cabinet. You see a list of signals going in and out of this control cabinet. This is also for commissioning reasons. System checked, signal checked, signal checked, signal checked, and so on. External signals. And then, what else do we have here? Those two things in the back, the red ones, those are the motors for the pumps. The pumps are underneath the cover. So there's a screw type pumps here, two screw type pumps. Usually only one in operation, but they're changing. It's operational. And only in times when really a lot of oil is needed by a hydraulic system, we can even start a second pump. Okay, so these are the two pumps. And I always said, there must be somewhere a pressure relief valve. These are these things here. You see here is the pressure coming. And under this black hood, under this black cap, there you can adjust the spring. This is how this pressure relief valve look like. One for this pump and one for the other pump. Then this thing here, this red thing here, this is actually a filter, air filter. We also talked about this air filtration, because the level of the oil here will change, So we need to suck in air or get rid of air. And this is done via filter because I do not want, you see, it's dust environment. Here is a lot of dust. Okay, that's during construction time. However, who says that not somebody is putting up here new things, drilling holes and so on, and then I'll suck in the dirt? No, this is why it needs to be filtered. Needs to be filtered. So there is an air filter. This thing here, this red big thing here, this is also a filter case. Those with those screws and so on, they are usually low pressure filters. So this is for filling. There's a small, even a third pump, which you cannot see right now. It's somewhere in the back. And when we fill oil, we can do it via this filter. So we don't just pour the oil in. We already filter it. And we can even switch this filter to offline filtration, start the small pump and do the offline filter. There, it's this filter, this element. This here, this big one here, red part, this is the return line returning to the tank. This is a return line filter. Okay, so here we are using offline filter and an inline return line filter in this case. This thing here above, this is a pressure switch. So if the differential pressure is getting high, this will make a signal. Okay, this is the return line filter. In this case, there is even an inline filter, but only for parts of the hydraulic system, for the sensitive parts. With all those, there are here, this is a on this, especially this, this is a regulating valve. What this is about, we will hear. We will hear what this is about. This is very sensitive for dirt. So this part is filtered by this double filter here. You see it's a double filter, and you see it also looks different than this one. This is a high pressure filter. It's a pressure line filter, inline pressure line filter. Also here we have a switch for the differential pressure. That's that somewhere there's a light going on, bing, filter clocked. And this special double filter, I can simply turn over to the second filter element, and exchange the clocked filter element. This is why there is also this sheet metal part there, that we're not dripping oil somewhere down here. We're accumulating oil here. And the rest here, these are just these are valves, a lot of valves, which do something. I will not explain right now. Here we see here are pressure measurements and so on, which are connected somewhere to the cabinet, so that there is an automation system which can display the pressure and so on. And there's even, if there is no power, there's even a real analog pressure measuring instrument. There's a pressure switch here. Here, those two parts, these are level switches. You see, it pretty much looks the way we have discussed. Pretty much looks that way. And next video, you see it in the back here, this yellow thing, and also those other yellow things. This is a pressure accumulator, piston accumulator. Next video, we're going to talk about this stuff. Next video, we're going to talk about accumulators. How they work, what they are good for. In this case, they are, it's simply the case that the pump has not run all the time. But there are also other reasons. We will hear next video. For this time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.